Hey, it's Shahzadi, your registered dietitian. By now, most of you must be thinking, ah, Shahzadi, another coronavirus story. It's understandable, that's all we talk about and it's all getting a bit much, isn't it? However, have you taken a look at how nature is suddenly flourishing because of human beings being in lockdown? It's true, from the ozone layer miraculously healing to crystal clear waters in Venice and dolphins emerging in them, it's been a magnificent sight for all of us. Who knew that something as tragic as a global pandemic would have a silver lining for our planet, the environment, and its wildlife? These truly are incredible examples of orchestrated global action. But why has it taken us this long to listen to our planet's cries for help? Would we have listened if COVID-19 had not swept across the world in droves? Are we going to resort to our old habits again once all of this blows over? Now, if our own house is burning, we'd panic and call the fire department right away. Why then do we continue to treat the earth so callously? If we collectively did our part in taking climate change seriously, imagine how impactful it'll be. You may ask, what is climate change? Unfortunately, it's a long-term change in the average weather patterns that have come to define Earth's local, regional, and global climates. And these changes have a broad range of observed effects that are synonymous with the term. And despite being connected to each other through the tips of our fingers, we as people are more environmentally disconnected than ever. This is because we tend to disregard serious issues until they affect us directly. Yet, what we fail to remember is this. If we fail our planet, it will impact all of us categorically. After all, do we not have just the Earth to live on? Last year, the United Nations had an emergency meeting where they warned government officials and wider masses about only having 10 more years to prevent the Earth from irreversible climate change damage. Isn't this truly terrifying? What will become of our children and future generations? We are and will be letting them down. Yes, I do understand that laws are not rebuilt overnight. Government policies all over the globe need to adapt and change, whether that includes being tough on high-emission vehicles, minimizing or completely banning the use of plastic, or astronomically transforming waste management. Now, I'm not an expert on agricultural laws, but I do believe they play a vital role in making our planet more or less green. For example, if we link the global environment to farming, we can monitor how farmers inspect soil management, fertility, the use of pesticides, as well as pollution control and management. Now, this may encourage farmers to have a unified management system in order to strongly diminish farming's potentially adverse impact on the environment. And of course, as a registered dietitian, I would also like to shift our focus to enjoying more plants. Previously, I've spoken about the health benefits of a predominantly plant-based diet. Today, let's discuss its environmental impacts. Now, incidentally, plant-based diets are not to be confused by total veganism. They simply encourage us to cut down our overall intake of meat and animal products and include more plant-based proteins, fruits, and vegetables. This is because global food production also contributes to global warming. Agriculture, together with forestry, contribute to the emission of greenhouse gases. Livestock rearing contributes to global warming through methane gas that animals produce, as well as through deforestation and expansion of pastures. By taking measures as simple as increasing our intake of plant-based sources of protein, fruits and vegetables, we can have a tremendously positive impact in bringing climate change somewhat under control. Now, if you're seeking delicious plant-based inspiration, then don't forget to check out my website for nourishing and flavorful recipes. Not only are they quick and easy to make, but are also environmentally friendly. Now, we can also plan our meals in advance in order to limit toxic waste being dumped into landfills. Similarly, modifying the way we package our food and other items has a positive impact on the environment. This includes saying no to plastic and opting for reusable, sustainable, eco-friendly, and recyclable alternatives instead. Even multiple verses from the Quran vehemently reiterate the importance of being eco-friendly. As a practicing Muslim, it is my ultimate green guide. For example, take this ayah. And it is He, God, who has made you successors, Khalifa, upon the earth, and has raised some of you above others in degrees of rank, that He may try you through what He has given you. Indeed, your Lord is swift in penalty, but indeed He is forgiving and merciful. Now, this is a very powerful verse. In Arabic, the word Khalifa means guardian or friend of the earth. Since Allah has bestowed humans with the most powerful blessings of all, intelligence and free will, it makes perfect sense for us to take responsibility for our planet and to reassure it through regular health checks. Now, our planet and its civilization are in crisis. Don't you think the new coronavirus may be Mother Nature's brutal way of asking us to slow down? After all, we have been ignoring her previous cries for help. Now is the time to ponder over our actions and take small steps towards helping our planet. There are almost 8 billion of us. Surely, if we all make an active effort, we can bring this catastrophe under control. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up or leave me a comment. I'd love to know what nutrition and diet-related topics you want me to dive into next. Thanks for watching and don't forget to subscribe. Now, if you want to be a super subscriber, turn on that notification bell so you never miss another video.